So hi, my name is Alenka, and I'm a children's librarian at the Thomas Hughes Children's Library. Today, I'm going to guide you through a TinkerCad project on how to make a zipper pull. A zipper pull is the part of a zipper that you hold onto and you pull to zip or unzip a backpack or a coach. They look like these parts here. I've had a lot of zipper pulls break off my backpack or my winter coat, and it makes zipping them up much harder. So I'm going to show you how to design a customized one that will hopefully make your life a little bit easier. First, I'm going to show you how to find the project in TinkerCad because it's kind of hidden. Once you've logged into your TinkerCad account, click the Learn button on the top right-hand corner, and that will take you to this screen. Then hit Projects. Once the project screen loads, hit See All Projects. And now scroll all the way to the bottom. There is a two-part project here called Making Everyday Objects. We're going to click on part one, and you can see there's even a picture of a zipper right here. So these projects teach you how to make multiple objects, but you can skip around. So we're just going to hit Start next to the backpack zipper pull. Okay, I'm going to hit Next down here on the left just to get past the intro screens. And now we're ready to get started. So there's a little blurb up here explaining that the first thing we're going to do is make a comfortable grip for our fingers. Then it asks us to drag a sphere onto the work plane. Okay, and we're gonna resize the sphere to their exact measurements. So first I'm gonna click on this white box on the top of my shape. And then I'm going to drag it down until the number in the little measurement box goes down to 7. Then I'll click on this tiny black box on the side just to change the width, and I'll drag that down to 3 millimeters. And now I'm going to zoom in. And then I'll click on one of these white corner boxes. And now I can see the width and the length. And it's already 20 millimeters on this side. So I'm done with this step. Okay, so the instructions now tell me to select my sphere and then come up here to the edit menu to the top left and hit duplicate, which is this box that has split into other boxes. When you click duplicate, TinkerCAD makes a second shape identical to the one that you've selected, and it places it right on top of that original shape. So when I hit the arrow key twice, it moves my new second shape 2 millimeters to the right, and I can see now that I have two shapes. I need 8 of these lined up, so I'm going to hit duplicate 6 more times. And duplicate now, it'll move each one over 2 millimeters for you. Last step in this section, I need to select all 8 spheres, which I will do by clicking in an empty spot on the work plane. I'll hold down the mouse clicker or the trackpad if you're using a laptop trackpad, and then I can draw a box around them. Then I'm going to come up to this menu on the top right and hit this group button. So all 8 spheres are one solid object. Perfect. So the next step asks me to drag a box onto the work plane and then make it 20 millimeters wide and 20 millimeters long or 20 millimeters deep. So objects default to 20 by 20 millimeters, so I don't need to actually change the length or width. To change the height, I'm going to click in this white box on the top of my shape, click in the measurement box, type 1, and hit enter. And now I can go back up here to the shapes pane and turn my box into a hole. Okay. So next I need to move the grip until it's on top of the box. Oh no, I'm gonna undo. I just wanna move it. And once they seem pretty lined up, that looks pretty good. I'm going to select both shapes and group them together. So there we go. So now if I change my view, I zoom way in from the bottom, you can see they're flat on the bottom. And that just makes sure it prints nice and sturdy. Okay, so next we're gonna make the piece that will attach to the actual zipper. I'm gonna move this guy to the side, and you need a round roof shape, which is this one. So we need to rotate our shape so that one of these smaller flat ends is lying flat on the work plane. But first I'm gonna rotate it so it's kind of facing the grip. To do that, I need to click on this black shape that looks like a half circle. That gives me little tick marks, 360 degrees around the object. Now I can rotate it 90 degrees. Then I can use that same tool, but on top of the shape. I can rotate it another 90 degrees, maybe. There, okay. So now a smaller flat edge is facing down. The roof shape is under the work plane a bit, that's okay. We're gonna make it float 1 millimeter above the work plane, or we're gonna move it up until it's 1 millimeter above on the Z axis. So I'm going to use this black triangle, and that will let me drag it up until I get a positive one. Now you can kind of see, oops, we're floating above the work plane. Okay, it's time to resize the roof. We've deviated from this TinkerCAD lesson a little bit already. You can play with your measurements here on out. It will help you customize your zipper pull more, but I'm gonna start with their suggested measurements. So if I click on the white square on the bottom of my shape, I can see how wide or how long it is, or this is its measurement along the x-axis, this is the measurement along the y-axis. The lesson suggests you make your roof shape 12 millimeters along the y-axis. So I'll click in this box, hit 12, and hit enter. And then I'm gonna click in this box down here, change 10 to 20, and hit enter. So this is now 20 millimeters along the x-axis. So finally, I'm gonna click on the box on the top of the shape. This is the height. The project suggests you change this to 4 millimeters. That means the part of the zipper pull that attaches to the zipper itself is gonna be 4 millimeters thick. If your zipper pulls break a lot, you might want to make this piece a little bit thicker so it's stronger. I wouldn't make it more than 5 millimeters. That way it matches the grip in size. And the last thing we need to, we need to center our new shape on the zipper pull grip. So I'm gonna use alignment to do this. I'm going to select both objects so I can draw a box around them, or the project tells you in the end of this step, I can hit the Command or Control key on my keyboard, and then A, Control A is select all, and that also captures both shapes. Then I'm going to come up to the menu on the top right and select this tool that looks like a little bar graph. That's alignment. Oops, this one, that's alignment. So alignment draws these lines along each shape. And if I click on one, say in the center, it makes sure the objects are both lined up perfectly center. I also need to make sure there's a fair amount of overlap between my shapes, at least a couple of millimeters. So to keep my objects aligned center, I can move this piece with just the left arrow key on my keyboard until it overlaps with the grip. That far. And that will help to make sure that the zipper pull is strong and less likely to break. So once that's done, I can select all again and hit group. Now my T-shapes are one object. Okay, so we're almost done. The last crucial shape is to create a hole in the zipper pull so you can tie like string or yarn through it and then also through the zipper, and that will connect them. First we need a cylinder. The project tells you to drag a solid cylinder to the work plane and turn it into a hole. I'm going to be lazy and grab one that's already a hole. And we need it to be 5 millimeters tall. Five. and 3 millimeters in diameter. So I'm going to click on these white squares again to get the measurements. To change a cylinder's diameter, you have to change the measurement on both the X and the Y axis. So this 3 and 3. And then finally, I'm going to drag the whole cylinder over to my zipper pole and place it roughly where I want. Right there. So if you want to be done here, you can group all your objects together, call it a day, use a zipper pole. You have a few options to decorate or customize your zipper pole. So I'm going to hold off on grouping everything because I might want to move this hole a little bit. There are lots of fun decorative shapes in TinkerCAD. So you have a lot of options. Let's say I want to add a star to my zipper pole. So I'll drag this star shape onto my work plane. And the shape's default size is way too big. So I'm going to resize it down just to make it easier to work with. If I click on one of the white squares around the star, and then I hold down shift on my keyboard, I can resize the star proportionally. So I'm changing the measurements on the X, Y, and the Z axis all at the same time. So it looks like a star still. I want the star to fit in the space between the grip and between the hole. So I'm just going to eyeball this. That looks like a good size. And I'll adjust it in a second. So now I can either make my star sit on top of the zipper pole, or I can use it to kind of emboss the zipper pole. Either way, I need it to be floating higher up, closer to the top of the zipper pole. So I know I made this part of the zipper pole 4 millimeters. So I'm gonna raise the star up just like 3, 2, 3. No, that's 4. Now I'm gonna see how it fits. I think it might not fit. Yeah, it's too big. So since my star has lots of points, I'm going to rotate it a little bit. Here we go. So those are kind of sticking off the edge. And then I'm going to shrink it a teeny bit more. And I don't mind the star points sticking out the way that they are. If you do, you can change that. Like, I'm going to lose this edge of the star, so maybe if I shrink it more, I won't lose so much of the star, and I can even nudge it down. Once I've got the star where I want it, I can group these all together, again, call it done. So it will print just like this with the star sticking out of the top and kind of out of the sides of the shape. If you want the star to be more of an imprint, you can change that object into a hole. And now if I group everything together, yeah, now I have this star-shaped imprint. I tried to make my star only like 1 millimeter deep into the zipper pole. So if you decide you want this kind of like embossed, carved out style, just as a warning, the thinner that this gets, the weaker it will be. So if this is for, say, your winter coat, that might be okay. But if you have a backpack that gets really heavy or that you toss around a lot, like I have a backpack I just pack full of groceries and I've broken all of the zipper poles on that backpack, you might want to make this part thicker so that it's stronger. The final step in the lesson tells you how to download your zipper pole file, and you'll need to do that to send your file to us to print. It also helps ensure you don't lose your work. TinkerCAD should automatically save to your dashboard once you complete this project, once you hit this done button. I've occasionally had bugs with that in the past, so you can always save it just to be safe. But that is it. Thank you. Have fun, and I'm excited to see your designs.